What's up, everybody? You know, as a lot of you guys know, I try to keep my private life just that. You guys know that. You guys know I try to keep my private life as private as I can. Because like everybody else, I enjoy my privacy. Now, 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 Percy, don't go saying shit right now. Now, I'm not siding with what he did, but we'll get to that in a minute. But I do want to say something right now. Gordon Ray Wilkins, I'm calling you the fuck out. Not as a YouTube persona or whatever. I'm calling you out as your son. You see, what you did to me on Marty's panel was fucked up how you disowned me. That was fucked up. But there's one thing you cannot deny. That you went about getting a hold of me the wrong fucking way. You trusted the wrong fucking people. You trusted the wrong fucking scumbags. When you went up on Marty's panel, Gordon, you didn't put your trust in friends and people that were telling you the truth. No, you put your trust in a bunch of pedophiles. The very people that you say that you're against. So what I don't understand is this. What I'm trying to understand is this. Why didn't you just reach out to me first? Why didn't you get a hold of me in private? Why didn't you come to me as a man and ask me what the fuck is really going on? I don't understand it. Why didn't you just fucking get a hold of me? I'm a good guy. I'm not that hard to reach. Anybody here in chat can tell you for themselves. I'm not hard to get a hold of at all. In fact, I'm pretty damn fucking easy to get a hold of. I'm pretty damn fucking easy to get a hold of. Turn Joker here knows it. Bomb Rippers knows it. Everyone here fucking knows how easy I am to get a hold of. Here's the thing, Bomb Rippers. I knew how to get a hold of this man the whole time. But you want to know why I didn't reach out to you, Gordon? Because when we had that fight back in 2014... I didn't know if you still hated me or not. So I gave you your space. I gave you your time. That's why I didn't reach out to you. Because I didn't know if you were still mad at me about that fight or not. I didn't know. But let me tell you right now, Gordon, you might think I'm a piece of shit, and that's fine. But one thing you need to understand and get through your fucking head myself and my boy Tibbs, who is basically family to me at this point. The man that I'm proud to call my brother Tibbs, me and him both have all the proof in the world to show that I'm not what you think I am. These people that you trusted, they can't be trusted, Gordon. They're bad fucking people. They are the thing that you seek. You said you seek out to take down pedophiles, right? Well, you were right there on panel with them. You were right there on panel with them, Gordon. Now, I'm not out here to fight with you. I'm not coming out here to start shit with you, no. I'm here to ask you for your help. Because you have connections. You have connections to people that can help shut these motherfuckers down. And you know you do. So I'm out here asking you, not as a man, but as your son and a fellow hater of pedophiles, will you join me and Tibbs in shutting these people down? Because we have all the proof in the world to shut them down. But we need your help. We need your boys, your biker crew. We need your MC to help us out. We have all the info in the world to give to you. We need your help. So what do you say, Gordon? What do you say we set our differences aside and shut these motherfuckers down? Because these pedophile motherfuckers need to be shut down. And I've got all the proof in the world to show that I'm not a pedophile. I have all the proof in the world to show that. And I have proven that. Why do you think the trolls don't fuck with me anymore? Because they're afraid of Tibbs. Because Tibbs called them the fuck out. He called out N-word boy, mass troll fuckface mafia. Every single troll, every single pedophile that deserved to be called out, he called them out. And because of him, I'm away from that shit now. I've been away from that shit for almost a month now. And I'm happy about that. I'm proud of that. I'm proud to be able to say that I get a chance to be myself again. But Gordon, I need to know, do you stand with me and Tibbs? Or do you stand against us and stand with those pedophile motherfuckers? I need to know. I need to know who you stand with, Gordon. Because if you stand with us, you stand against pedophiles like you claim. But if you go on and you believe them, then you stand against us and you yourself are a pedophile by association. And I don't want to see that for you. How do you think your biker leader, how do you think your chapter president is going to feel when he finds out that one of his own boys is running with pedophiles? I know if I was in his shoes, I would hate it if one of my boys got caught being a pedo supporter. Because when you panel up with them, Gordon, you support pedophiles. Just know that. Like I said, I'm not telling you what to do. You're a grown-ass man. You're 70-some-odd years old. You can make your own choices. But one thing you need to understand, Gordon, is that if you don't help us, you yourself are a part of the problem. So I need to know, old man, will you help us? Will you help us stop these scumbags? Because these people targeted me. They targeted Mom. They targeted Tibbs. They targeted all of our friends. Threw a brick through Mom's windshield of her car. Put my life in danger. Tried to have me arrested just so I could be murdered in prison. Which they failed at that. And no, it is this, Mike. It's just I got everything turned down really low. But like I said, this is just a handful of things that they've done to me, that they've done to Tibbs, that they've done to Mom. They set off bombs in our fucking yard. They have threatened to terrorize innocent people. These people have caused people to end their lives. And 2 years ago, I was almost one of them. 2 years ago, I was almost one of those people that ended their lives because of these people. So I'm asking you, Gordon, will you help us? Or will you stand against us, and do I have to tear you down too, the same way that Tibbs tore N-Word Boy down? Because if Tibbs could tear down N-Word Boy that quick, how fast do you think it'll be before he tears you down if you stand with them? Because trust me when I say, Gordon, you don't want to be my enemy. And I'm not saying that as a challenge. I'm saying that out of fact, out of reality. Reality is, Gordon, these people that you got up on panel with are scum. And I'll admit, what you did to me did hurt. When you disowned me, that did hurt. I'll admit that. When you disowned me in front of over 1,000 people, that did hurt. I'll give you that. That hurt like hell. Because when you disowned me, I felt like I lost not only a hero that I looked up to as a kid, and somebody as a kid that I wanted to be so much like. One sec, y'all. What? Sorry, they all had to take care of something real quick. But like I said, Gordon, when you disowned me in front of those thousands of people, that shit did hurt. A lot. It really did. You want to know what I did those next 3 days after? And this isn't just for you, Gordon. This was for everybody in chat as well. So you guys know exactly what it is that I went through those next 3 days. Those next 3 days after you disowned me, I didn't know what to think. I didn't know how to feel. I didn't know whether I should be mad, upset, angry, pissed off. I was sick to my stomach, almost to the point of throwing up for 3 days straight. Because the man that I looked up to, the man that I idolized as a kid, the man that was my motherfucking hero, the man that taught me to always stand up for America, the man that taught me to always do the right thing, the man that taught me to always stand up for the weak no matter what, the man that I took pride in calling my dad, disowned me in front of over 1,000 people. And for what? Because you wanted to believe some fucking lie that the trolls told you? Instead of reaching out to me, you went on panel and you believed their fucking lies before even questioning me. Before even coming to me and asking me. How do you think that made me feel? How do you think that made Mom feel? How do you think that made the rest of the family feel, Pops? Huh? How do you think that made the rest of the family feel? Because let me tell you, no one else in the family was hurt more than I was. Because like I said, I used to look up to you. I used to admire you. I used to see my dad, you. I used to see you going to work every day. And you know what's funny? You were the reason why I wanted to get into the military straight out of high school. Despite me having one kidney, I still wanted to enlist. And you're the reason why for that. You're the reason why I wanted to follow in your footsteps and join the army. You're the reason why. Because you taught me to always do what's right and to put others before yourself. To always stand up for others and do what's right. And what I want to know is this. What happened to that you that you used to be when you were in the military? What happened to you? Because the dad that I knew, the Gordon Ray Wilkins that I knew, that I grew up with as a kid, the man that fucking helped raise me, the man that taught me right from wrong, the man that taught me to not take shit from anyone, the man who always taught me to fight back against my bullies. Look at you now. Drunk. All the time. Believing the lies of others before your own family. And here's the thing, Gordon. You may have disowned me. And like I said, I'm okay with that. But there's something you need to know. I never once disowned you. And never would. Because even though you may have disowned me, I still care about you. I still care about you as a person and as a human being. And actually, then I'm going to try 23. You know what's sad, Gordon? You know what's sad about you? The fact that you believe these scumbag people over your own son. The fact that you believed them before even reaching out to me. But that's why I'm here right now asking you, will you help us shut these people down? Now I understand how it might look from your perspective. And I respect that and I understand that. I do. I truly 110% wholeheartedly understand where you're coming from with that. I do. I get it. You know, from the way things look, it would look that way. But one thing you need to understand about my world, about this place on the internet that I call my home, just like I call the house that I'm in right now home, this place right here, YouTube, Kick, Twitch, they are all my home. They are a place for me to hang out with like-minded people that enjoy my content, that want to see me do good, that in turn, I want to see them succeed as well. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Black Dragon, but that's never going to happen. I'm never going to stay off. No, nobody's messed with me today at all. Not once. And I'm glad about that. Like I said, Gordon, I wouldn't be up on here asking for your help if we didn't need it. Gordon, you have connections to people that can help shut all this down, and you know it. Actually, no, he is not my stepdad. He is my adoptive dad. My stepdad is Ed. My adoptive dad is Gordon. Gordon is the one that helped to raise me half my life. And like I said, he's the reason why I genuinely wanted to join the military. He really is. He's the whole reason why I wanted to join the military in the first place. Because my own dad, Gordon, inspired me to want to do that. To want to follow in his footsteps and join the army. In a sense, yeah, pretty much you could say. But like I said, Gordon is the reason that I wanted to join the military so badly as a kid. All throughout my whole high school career, I did everything I could to be able to join the military. Did everything, and I do mean everything. I went through ROTC the whole fucking nine. But unfortunately, due to me having one kidney and my medical condition, that would have made me a liability because of that one kidney, unfortunately, I wasn't able to join. Which did hurt. It did. Yes, I did. I took every single fucking test that I could take. But unfortunately, due to my medical condition of me having one kidney, they would not allow me to join. Because they saw that as a liability. Which did suck. But I also understand why they did what they did. And I'm not mad at them. But Gordon, you need to understand. As a kid, you were my fucking hero. You were the man that I wanted to be like so badly as a kid. You inspired me to want to join the military. You inspired me to do what's right no matter what. That's why I'm standing here right now. Not just as a man. Not just as somebody that wants to do right in this world. But as your son, and as somebody that wants to help bring down bad people. Will you join us? Will you help me and Tibbs shut these people down? Because if you'll help us, I will openly apologize to you. I'll apologize for the things that I said to you. I have no problem with that. I have zero issue with apologizing to you. Because I'll admit, there were some things that I said that were out of hand. I'll admit that. I will openly admit to you, Gordon, that I was wrong about a lot of the shit that I said to you. About how you're a loser and how you're a piece of shit. I will gladly take that all back. But I need to know if you and your MC will stand with us. I'll explain to your chapter president what's going on. I'll explain that to him full force. I have no problem with that. Because I have the evidence to back everything up. I have every shred of evidence, every little bit of proof to show that these people are terrorists. And to show that these people are actual pedophiles. Like I said, Gordon, the choice is yours. I'll be waiting for your answer. And if you want to message me, get a hold of me on Facebook. Or you can reach out to me by any means necessary. If you can't get a hold of me on Facebook directly, ask somebody for my Facebook. Someone will give it to you. And if you need my email, they'll get you that too. But I need to know, Gordon, will you help us to stop these people? Because there's one person that these people will not tell you about that about 2 or 3 years ago took his own life. And that person is from TikTok. And that person's name is the Inquisitor. And the Inquisitor was a good fucking dude. He's somebody that I actually enjoyed watching. Now, I didn't know him personally, but I knew his content. I used to watch a lot of his content every chance I got. I was actually a really big fan of what the dude was doing. He was a good fucking dude. Had good content, was minding his own business. And then what happened? People hated him so much that they wanted to make up a lie about him, calling him a pedophile, faking fucking messages, and all kinds of shit. And then what happened? As a result, he took his own life. Because these very same people are the same ones that go after me, that go after Tibbs, that go after people that I fucking care about. Like I said, Gordon, I'll give you a chance to respond. I'll give you a chance and give you all the answers you need if you just reach out to me and stop being such a bullheaded fucking jackass. And I'm not saying that out of disrespect either. I'm not. Because you are fucking bullheaded and you know it. Where do you think I get my stubbornness from, Gordon? I get it from you. I get my thick-headedness from you. Which, in a lot of ways, has served me quite well. So, thank you for that. But Gordon, like I said, man, I'm not asking you as a man. I'm asking you as your own son. Granted, like I said, I know to you I might not be family, but to me, you will always be my dad. You will always be my old man. You will always be my dad. Regardless of whether you accept that or not, that's on you. But just know that I will always be your son, like it or not. Yes, I may not be your son by blood, and that's fine. But at the end of the day, you helped raise me. Therefore, as far as I'm concerned, you will always, until the day you die, be my old man. You will always be my dad, no matter what. Regardless of what you think or say. Regardless of whether you still want to disown me or not, that's fine. If you want to disown me after this, fine. But just know that I will always care about you. I will always be your son. To me, you will always be my dad. And that's why I'm asking you right now, Gordon, as I've said these last few minutes, will you help us shut them down? Because these people are Nazi terrorists that terrorize innocent lives every day. These people terrorize innocent lives every day for the sake of nothing more than to get a laugh. Seeing people terrorized brings them joy. Making people look like pedophiles who stand against them brings them joy. Watching people like me be bullied and attacked because I look different brings them joy. Like I said, Gordon, I'm asking you not just as a man, but also as your son. Will you help me and TibbzTV shut down this terrorist troll community? This terrorist pedophile cult. Will you help us shut them down? Because they have more numbers than we do, and we need all the numbers we can get. Like I said, Gordon, I care about you. You will always be my dad, regardless. But as I said, right now is not the time for debating that. Right now is the time for action, Gordon. You talk about your motorcycle club being against pedophiles. I saw your biker cut. I know what you guys are about. What, you don't think I'm not cultured in that shit? You don't think that I ain't got friends that are bikers as well? You forget, Gordon. You helped raise me. I was raised around that shit my whole life. I was raised around bikers. You seem to forget that. I was raised around you enough to know what a biker is, and I know all the terminology as well. I know what cuts are, I know exactly what the patches are, I know all that shit. Like I said, I know what your MC is about. And I respect that. I respect what your MC is about. How they want to go out and do good for people. I respect that. I do. Wholeheartedly, I respect the shit out of that. But if you really want to do good, then help us to shut this terrorist group down before anyone else gets hurt and before anyone else takes their own life. Because like I said, a couple years ago, I was almost one of those people that took their own life. God only knows how many people took their own lives because of these people. And I'm telling you guys this in chat too. If any of you guys know anybody that's on board for helping out, let me know. Reach out to me. You guys know how to get a hold of me. If you guys know anybody that truly wants to help to shut these guys down and isn't afraid to get a little bit dirty with these motherfuckers and isn't afraid to go toe-to-toe with these terrorists, fucking let me know. Reach out to me on Facebook. Because these people need to be stopped. And to answer your question, Luminous, right now I do not. The only way that I make money right now is through donations. That's the only way I'm able to make any kind of money right now off of these streams is through donations. Here's something for you guys that I bet a lot of y'all didn't know. Honestly, man, surprisingly not that much. You'd actually be surprised at how little donations I get on here, man. You'd be surprised. And trust me when I say Luminous. And Luminous, what I'm going to do, man, is I'm going to add you to my Facebook where I have TibbzTV so I can introduce you guys. That way y'all can talk. Because Luminous, I talk to you outside of social media, man, and you're a good fucking dude. You're a real good dude. I enjoyed hanging out with you, man, for real. You're a good fucking dude. Hey, just in time. Message me on Facebook, man. And let me know that it's you, bro. Message me on Facebook and let me know that it's you, man. That way I know it's you and not some fucking weird random person. Because, Luminous, I can tell you right now, between you and Tibbs, you guys can make an amazing fucking plan together. You guys really could. Because Tibbs, he's fucking hella smart. This dude's one of the smartest motherfuckers I've ever met in my life. And I'm not even joking when I say that either. TibbzTV is fucking super smart, man. Dude's probably one of the smartest dudes I've ever met. For real. And I'm not just saying that because he's a friend and because he's a brother. But no. This dude genuinely is smart. He's very knowledgeable in a lot of stuff. Stuff that you wouldn't even think he knows about. He actually knows quite a bit. Tibbs is TibbzTV. TibbzTV is the man that helped me to escape these terrorist trolls almost a little under a month ago. Which is why I've had so much free time on my hands. Which is why I've been able to do so many streams for you guys. Which is why I've been able to be myself again after 8 to 9 years of being held captive in my own home, being made to live in fear. This man freed me of that shit. Now, whether the trolls want to admit it or not, that's on them. But like it or not, whether they like it or not, I'm free from that shit. I no longer follow what they want. You want to know when the last time I watched a Marty stream was? You really want to know? The last time I ever watched a Marty stream on my own accord was almost 2 months now. Almost 2 months of not watching a Marty stream. Because I don't care to watch that toxic garbage. I don't care to see toxicity. I care to see acceptance, succeeding, people succeeding, doing what they love to do, people enjoying doing what they love. I love to see people succeed in doing what they want to do with their life as far as being a good person. I love people seeing achieve their goals on streams, you know, getting their subscriber count up, following their dreams. That's the kind of content I enjoy watching. That's the kind of content that I tune into. And that's true, dude. A lot of people act like I'm a bad dude. But Luminous, you've talked to me several times already, dude. And you're a good fucking dude. And even you can tell right off rip just from talking to me, I'm a chill motherfucker. I'm chill as fuck. I'm not about the drama. I'm about having a good time and being there for my people. I'm about creating a good environment and having fun with people like you and Justin Time and even Drift X and Blue X. That's what I'm about. I enjoy y'all's company, man. I'm not even gonna lie. Y'all are cool as fucking hell, man. Exactly. And I never will stop keeping up with that shit either, mind you. And that's a question that I would love to have answered that I may never get the answer to. I would love to find out how. I mean, I got a few hunches as to who it could have been that dug out the information. But I'm not going to say anything because I don't know if it was them for sure. So I'm not going to say any names. See what I'm saying? Like, I have my hunches of who it could be, but I don't know for sure. So I'm not going to jump the gun and say anything. If that makes sense. Because that motherfucker ain't even allowed on this channel. Because I'm trying to make this place a positive energy place for you guys. I'm trying to make this place a positive place for you guys to come and hang out and have a good time and not have to worry about being attacked. You guys can come in. We can all hang out together and shoot the shit. You know, if anybody wants to hop in a game of Fortnite or GTA, fuck it, we'll hop on, we'll get it in on stream, we'll have a good time. That's the kind of shit that I'm about, dude. I don't do drama. Drama is for losers, okay? Oh, bro, you can bet your ass I got that Forza unlocked, boy. You already know. You already know your boy's got that Forza 5 unlocked, bro. You already know this. You already know that once this stuff's said and done, y'all already know that I'm going to be going back to that Forza full time, man. Once this whole thing is said and done, once this shit is said and done within this year, you can bet your ass I'm going back to my roots as on a Forza game, for sure. And a lot of people don't know this, but I didn't start out on Forza Horizon 1. And a lot of people don't know that. I did not start out on Forza Horizon 1. I started out, ironically, on Forza Horizon 4. I started out on number 4, and then worked my way and bounced around up until number 5. I started out on Horizon 4, then played number 2, then 3, then 1, and now I'm on 5, so I kind of bounced around a little bit. Yeah, they locked me out of my main Xbox account. That don't mean I don't got backups though, boy. Kinda like my Twitch account. They thought that they could take away my Twitch. But little do they know, I had 20 other Twitch accounts on lock, ready to go at a moment's notice. Favorite Pokemon? I know this is kind of a weird one, but bro, motherfucking Blaziken, bro. Blaziken is a fucking beast. But that's my third favorite. My top two, Mew and motherfucking Mewtwo are my top two. Mew, Mewtwo, and Blaziken are my top three. Now, if we're going off a show, then obviously the main one, Pikachu. That's pretty obvious, bro. Yo, Marowak's a fucking boss. Not even gonna lie, bro. Marowak's a fucking beast. Now, if we're talking legendary type Pokemon, like the legendary ones from the movies, motherfucking Suicune is at the top of my motherfucking list for legendaries, bro. Suicune, Lugia, and that's a toss-up between Celebi and I can't remember what the other one was. It was from one of the new ones. I can't remember what the name it is, but yeah. Those are just a few of the legendaries that I rock with. But like I said, man, if you guys have any way to reach out to me, do so. If you guys are seriously on board, like if you guys are seriously on board with like my boy Luminous is here, or Justin Tom is, if you guys are very serious about jumping on board and aren't afraid to get a little bit dirty, then by all means, hit me up. I'll link you guys up with my brother Tibbs, and we'll get shit going, man. Because these people need stopped. Bad. Oh yeah, dude, I grew up with the classic stuff, man. I grew up with the classic Pokemon, motherfucker. I mean, come on, dude. I have Season 1. Episodes 1, 2, and 3 of Pokemon on VHS. Still in good condition. What does that tell you? And yes, for those of you wondering, yes, I still do use a VHS player. Fuck you. I still do use a VHS player. I still use a VCR, motherfuckers. Not for all my shows and movies, but for the older ones that aren't, you know, that aren't out on DVD or on streaming platforms. I watch it on VHS. Dope. Hey, yo, Luminous. Favorite DBZ character? Matter of fact, what's y'all's, and for anybody in the comments, man, what's y'all's favorite DBZ character? I can already tell you mine right off fucking rip, dude. My boy motherfucking Gohan, bro. Alright, Android 17, respect, man, respect. Android 17's good, respect. But man, I gotta go with my boy Gohan, bro. Classic Gohan, man. Teen Gohan going up against fucking Cell, bro. Whipping ass, dude, straight up. Yo, Trunks is good too, man, not gonna lie. My top three favorites, Gohan, Trunks, and... I know it's going to be a weird one, but I would have to probably go with fucking Bardock. Just because Bardock's a fucking badass motherfucker. Plus he's Goku's dad, so I mean, what do you expect? But dude, Gohan and Trunks as a team, bro, game over. And bro, everybody's always wondering what this stuff is that they call sludge. Like, you know how a lot of people say that, like, oh, I drink sludge? You wanna know what they're really talking about? They're talking about the thing, what do I drink every day, man? For those of you guys that have been around for a while, y'all know me. What do I always drink on besides soda? What do I drink on? Besides soda every day, man. What's the first thing I drink on when I get up in the morning? Oh, shit. What's the first thing that almost everybody drinks on when they get up in the morning? I'll give you a hint. It's in the chat right now. It has to do with fucking Starbucks. Yup. They call... What I drink on, which is coffee, they call that shit sludge. Why? I don't know. It's just a thing, man. It is what it is. At least that's what the trolls consider it. To me, coffee is motherfucking coffee. Hey. You're not wrong, dude. You are not wrong, man. I'll take a nice hot cup of coffee in the morning over bullshit any day of the week. Hell. I'll take a nice hot campfire and a nice hot cup of coffee over drama any day of the week. Straight up. Because that's how I am, dude. I don't do drama. Dude, coffee's my fucking blood, bro. I swear to God. You take me to the doctors... They won't get blood, they'll get fucking coffee, bro. I'm like a human coffee machine. Swear to God. I drink so much coffee, man, my blood's practically made of this shit. I go to the doctor, they're always like, oh, we're gonna take your blood. Oh, what's this? Oh, sorry, I forgot to tell you. My blood's not blood, it's coffee. Sorry. But hey, you get free coffee. Grab you a cup, it's free. And bro, I think coffee is everybody's gasoline, man. Let's be honest here. I think half the world runs on coffee and not gas. I'll tell you why. Because he has an MC that's massive and that spans several states long that are against pedophiles. That's why. His MC was built around stopping pedophiles. And that MC spans not only in Florida, but it spans several states. And I do mean several states. Can you imagine having that kind of firepower in your back pocket when it comes to these asshole pedos? Can you imagine having that kind of firepower going up against these terrorists? And think about that. All of us, plus their MC, versus these terrorists over here on the internet talking shit. I mean, think about that for a minute. Do you know how quickly they would run scared? Pretty damn fast. Let's just say that. It'd be pretty fucking quick. I'm gonna lower this down a bit. Oh, and also, as for y'all wondering about, am I going to be doing GTA content again? Well, you have your answer. Y'all were wondering about me doing GTA content the other day, right? Well, I got an answer for you guys. My answer to being able to do GTA content, the answer is yes. Oh, and by the way, Tibbs, massive shout out to you, bro. And a lot of people want to know, why am I giving Tibbs props for GTA? Well, let me tell you, this motherfucker went out of his way and fucking bought me that damn shit. So I can continue to make amazing content for you guys, not just on here, but on YouTube as well. So, to N-word boy, I say this. Ha ha, fuck you. Tibbs always wins. Oh, and Tibbs, by the way, again, thank you for doing that for me, man. I do appreciate it, bro. I do appreciate you picking that up for me so I can actually continue to make good content for these wonderful people. I do appreciate that, man. 100% I appreciate that. So, starting either tomorrow morning or tonight, I will actually be doing... I actually managed to find one of my older accounts off of Xbox, ironically. And trust me when I say, I got more money on that account than I will ever need. So I will be using that account to do the different stuff for you guys, for sure. So that'll be fun. You guys get to see me fly around some scramjets, do a few drift runs with some actual good cars, and just raise havoc and raise hell. Which is pretty cool. I didn't think I still had access to the account. Not my main account, but an older account that I had before the Cyraxx one that got broke into. And we're talking spanning back to like Xbox 360 days. Like, that's how far back this account goes, man. Thankfully, I was able to transfer my info and all the stuff I had from then over to the Xbox One version of shit, so we are good, man. But what I'm doing right now, before I do any kind of content for you guys, I'm getting all my stuff squared away on there. I'm getting everything set up, squared away, set up, ready to go. So, yeah. You guys can look forward to me doing GTA 5 content starting tomorrow. It's going to be some down the wall, because in the morning I am going to come up with a new intro for my YouTube channel. And some stuff for here as well. Now, I am going to say this. If you guys do want to help, alright, so before I get into that, let me ask y'all something. How badly do you guys want some merch? Bing bong. What up, Seth? What up, Bing bong, Seth? How you doing, bro? Well, we look forward to someone else playing again. Hey, it is what it is. Not what? You're not a merch, bro. Trust in what I say, man. This merch I was gonna drop, if y'all helped me get to 1,000 subs on YouTube, man, you would have loved the merch I was gonna drop. But hey, since you're not a merch guy, hey, it's all good. And the reason why I ask how many of y'all are wanting some merch is because I have a deal for you guys. If y'all can help me get to 1,000 subs over on my YouTube channel, which I will post a link to, if y'all can help me get to 1,000 subs on YouTube, I'll make a merch shop that they can't fuck with. Ah, Bastion, another troll. There, y'all. For now, I'm going to leave it right there with this. I got more work to do on my GTA 5 account. For those of you that did message me, I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. Like, the minute that I'm able to, I'm going to message you guys. And I'll link y'all up to Tibbz, man, and we'll get some shit rolling. What's my YouTube? Oh shit. Hold up. I'm gonna send that over to you right now. Hold on, what's up, buddy? Now, I don't have any videos up as of yet. I just got a couple shorts. But you guys are free to watch the shorts if you guys want to. They're pretty fucking cool. They were actually made by a fan, so that counts for something. Man, y'all, that being said, I'm about to bounce for now, and I'll catch you guys later on, man. Do I play COD? Yes, I do. And I got you, man, no worries. But with that being said, man, I'll catch y'all later, man. I'm out of here, y'all. Peace.